Hello students, today we are going to discuss about counseling and therapy. So in this subject there are two concepts are there. So we will see what is counseling and what is therapy and how the counseling and therapy goes together. See, counseling and therapy, that is a particularly one of the technical application of the therapies in the counseling process. So therapy is nothing but the application of the different techniques as per the assessment of the problem of the individual. So therapeutic counseling is a psychological service that focuses on helping individuals learn skills and techniques to facilitate coping, make improvements in their own lives. So when individual comes to the counselor with different problems as per the scenario, so what we does in the counseling is we first analyze what is the problem and we see that what is the diagnosis, and on the basis of diagnosis we usually apply the different techniques which mainly adopted from the different theories of psychology. So what is the meaning of counseling? Counseling, according to the American Counseling Association, counseling is the application of mental health, psychological or human development principles through cognitive, affective, behavioral or systematic interventions. So the strategies that mainly addresses the wellness, personal growth or career development as well as pathology. So when we apply all these aspects mainly for the positive change, we adopt few of the techniques or skills mainly to help the client in solving his problems. So what some of the aims, if we see the what are all the aims of the counseling, counseling is mainly aims to provide the insight for the individual so that the person will get the what exactly he is going through, what is his problem and what exactly the feelings or the effects or what are the emotional changes which he is going through. So and some of the other aims, we can see that the person in the counseling, he is able to relate himself with the others, and mainly counseling also aims in giving the self-awareness. Self-awareness of what? Self-awareness of his own abilities and weaknesses, so that by understanding his abilities he will be able to cope his problems by making use of his abilities, and by understanding his weaknesses he will be able to see that which are all the areas exactly he has to do the interventions. So here counseling helps the client to understand himself, and by understanding himself he can connect with the problem and also he can connect with the others. Self-acceptance, very important aim of the counseling. See, many of the time people fail in accepting themselves, or accepting themselves in the sense they are not able to understand that I am only responsible for my problems. See, this is very important. So being a counselor, we need to make the client to understand that most of the time or many of the time we ourselves or he himself used to be the responsible for his problem. So that self-acceptance has to come. So when I accept myself responsible for the problem, I also take the responsibility to solve the problems. Otherwise what happens is individuals, they always blame because of that, because of him, because of her, because of them I am in the problem. No, actually we strive or we make the client to feel that I am responsible for my problem and I should try to come out of that. And self-actualization or individualization. So person should self-actualize, or he should understand that what exactly my aims. Counseling also aims to enlighten the individual. Enlightenment of what? Enlightenment of understanding himself, enlightenment of understanding his problems, enlightenment of coping mechanisms, and enlightenment to adjust with the maladjustment. Next, the counseling aims to solve the problems. Problem solving. See, it's a counseling process itself is a problem solving process, or it is a one of the method of problem solving approach. So throughout the process, The exact goal from the side of the counselor and also from the side of client is the problem solving. So when person into the counseling process, the exact goal of problem solving goes. Some of the other aims we can see that acquisition of social skills, very important. See the kinds of social skills like communication, adjustment and behavioral patterns. See, the are adjusting with the norms of the society. See, those are all the very important social skills every individual is in need. So here counseling helps the individual to acquire those social skills. Counseling also gives the psychological education. See, psychological education, if I give the example, see how to how to make use of the sense of humor, or how to laugh during the different situations, or how to be happy, or how to solve the problems, how to cope up with the situations, how to build a good social circle, how to build a friendly environment. See, these are all the social skills. These are all the social skills goes along with this. So how to keep my mental health, how to keep my mental health, and how I can be happy myself, and also how I can make others also happy. So these are all the things we mainly understand by the psychoeducation or psychological education. So counseling mainly helps in attaining those psychological education. Next is this cognitive change. Cognitive change is nothing but the changing the individual's negative thoughts to the positive thoughts. Most of the time, the client who comes to the counseling used to be with the negative thoughts. He comes with the bundle of negative ideas, negative thoughts, negative behaviors. So here in the counseling process, mainly we make the client to change from the positive negative thoughts to the positive thoughts. Behavior change, very important objective of the counseling. As I mentioned earlier, negative thoughts, same with the negative behaviors. So in the counseling process, we help the client to change the negative behaviors to the positive behavior. Obviously, the society always expect for the positive behaviors from everyone. It may be me, or it may be you, or it may be anyone. Okay, so here in the counseling process, we should understand what exactly the negative behaviors are there, and how by giving some coping strategies or by giving some techniques, how I can help the client to come out of that negative behaviors. Some of the system and counseling and therapeutic counseling also aims to do some systematic change. So for example, systematic change, I can give the example of marital counseling. See, many of the people who comes with the marital discords or extramarital affairs. So those are all the things which leads for the system changes in the society. So counseling aims to change those systematic changes which is happening in the individuals, okay, in the family wise or for himself, and also the societal aspect. So generativity of some and social action. Generativity is nothing but the developing the creativity among the individuals. See, every individual is a creative person, but the only thing is he needs some push up, or he need to triggered by someone else to understand his creativity. So counseling helps in generating those creativity and to do some social actions. Okay, see, for example, I can tell like this. Many of the clients, we used to suggest them, if the people are in the depression, just go and help someone so that you can you get some relaxation that I have helped someone. So you, that helps you to get the idea that okay, someone is getting help from me, so that I can I can reduce my some of the pains. Okay, so there are those kinds of examples. Those are all the aims of counseling. And overall, if we see what is the use of the counseling or therapeutic approach, is nothing but the empowerment of the human beings. So overall, we can see that counseling mainly done with the purpose of to empower the client to cope with the life situations, to reduce emotional stress, to engage in growth protecting activity, to have meaningful purpose or interpersonal relationship, and to make effective decisions. Okay, so if we are able to understand all these aims and objectives of the counseling, we will be able to understand that what all the techniques we can apply in the particular counseling process. So students, today it's a introduction, or it's a particular counseling is very much important, one of the important area, emerging area, which is in needed or required by everyone in the society. So these are all the gist of the therapeutic counseling.